Hola, ¿cómo están? Yo estoy bien. ¿Y ustedes? Espero que sí. Hoy vamos a continuar aprendiendo y repasando material de español 1. ¿Cómo estás? Today we're going to review cómo estás and different feelings and different verbs that you use to express feelings, such as tener, ser, and estar. For example, you can look here in these pictures how they are greeting each other and how one is asking someone else how that person is feeling or is doing that day. For that, in Spanish, we use tener, ser, and estar. Let's listen to this conversation to try to figure out what is going on here.
Hola Silvina, ¿cómo estás? Bien, gracias. ¿Y tú? Más o menos.
Hola, Silvina. ¿Cómo estás? Bien, gracias. ¿Y tú? Más o menos. So, as you can see, the expression ¿cómo estás? Means how are you? Using the verb estar. The answer to that would be bien, gracias. ¿Y tú? Más o menos. Más means more, menos means less. It translates to more or less, so-so. Let's listen to conversation B.
B.
¿Estás mal? ¿Estás enferma? No, no, estoy un poco triste porque yo estoy aquí y mi familia está lejos en Ecuador. Cuando yo estoy deprimida, me gusta escuchar música.
Okay, so Silvina says, ¿estás mal? ¿Estás enferma? No, no estoy un poco triste porque yo estoy aquí y mi familia está lejos en Ecuador. Cuando yo estoy deprimida, me gusta escuchar música. So, the conversation here, as you can see, is using different verbs to express how someone is feeling. ¿Estás mal? Are you feeling bad? ¿Estás enferma? ¿Enferma? Are you feeling sick? When you express any of these conditions, you use the verb estar. Notice how you use the verb first before you use the noun. ¿Estás enferma? ¿Estás mal? To generate, to formulate a question. Carmen says, no, estoy un poco triste. When you express feelings, you also use the verb estar. In English, we use the verb to be. You say, I am sad, right? Well, in Spanish, you also use the verb to be, but is the verb estar, not ser. Estoy un poco triste porque yo estoy aquí. You also use the verb estar to express location. Estoy aquí. I am here. Y mi familia está lejos. And my family is far away in Ecuador. En Ecuador. Cuando yo estoy deprimida, me gusta escuchar música. Again, the verb estar right here is used to express how someone is feeling. Cuando yo estoy deprimida, me gusta escuchar música. Let's listen to conversation C.
Sí.
A las 8 hay un concierto fantástico en el estadio. ¿Por qué no vamos? No sé. ¿Estás ocupada? No, entonces vamos. No sé, estoy cansada y tengo hambre.
A las 8 hay un concierto fantástico en el estadio. ¿Por qué no vamos? No sé. ¿Estás ocupada? No. Entonces, ¿vamos? No sé, estoy cansada y tengo hambre. As you can see, Silvina is asking Carmen if she wants to go to a concert. She says, at 8 o'clock, there is a concert, a fantastic concert in the stadium. Why don't we go? ¿Por qué no vamos? And Carmen says, no sé, I don't know. ¿Estás ocupada? Ocupada is occupied. In other words, busy. Are you busy? No. Entonces vamos. Then we go. No sé. Estoy cansada y tengo hambre. I am tired and I am hungry. Notice that here you use estoy cansada to express how you're feeling, how someone is feeling. And using tengo hambre, the verb tener, to express hunger, if you are hungry. So these are some of the vocabulary that you're going to use and we have to review. Estar means to be. Okay, you use estar for location, to express how someone is feeling, to express your opinion, things that may change, right? Things that are not set in stone, okay? An opinion, something that you feel at that moment, but it might change, okay? Estoy cansada, estoy cansado, I am tired, but I might not be tired later on, right? So that could change, so you use the verb estar. To specify location, you also use the verb estar. Estoy en la Florida. Estoy en Nueva York. Estoy en Sudamérica. Estoy. Estar. Also, to express, está muy bien. An expression. It is very good at this moment, right? But it may change. Alegre. Happy. Enojado. Angry. Estoy alegre. Estoy enojado. I am angry. Estoy nervioso. I am nervous. Estoy regular. I'm okay. Estoy tranquilo. I am calm. Now, to express other feelings like being hot, cold, or scared, you use the verb tener. Tengo calor. Tengo calor. I am hot. Tengo frío. I'm cold. Tengo miedo. I'm scared. Tengo sed. I am thirsty. To express those feelings, you use the verb tener, no the verb estar. Okay? So, let's continue. So, let's continue listening to this conversation.
De.
Yo también tengo hambre. Vamos a mi casa para comer y después vamos al concierto. Está bien.
Yo también tengo hambre. So let's continue with the conversation. Let's hear it.
De.
Yo también tengo hambre. Vamos a mi casa para comer y después vamos al concierto. Está bien.
Yo también tengo hambre. I am also hungry. Vamos a mi casa para comer y después vamos al concierto. We're going to my house to eat and later on we can go to the concert. Está bien. It's okay. All right. Sounds good. Está bien is another expression where you can use the verb estar. Está bien. It's okay. It's good. All right, let's do it. That's what it translates to. Okay, so here, let's listen to the last conversation right here.
Hey.
Estoy emocionada. La música va a ser fantástica. Carmen, mira quiénes están aquí. ¿Estás contenta? Sí.
Estoy emocionada. I am very excited, Silvina. La música va a ser fantástica. The music is going to be fantastic. Carmen, mira quiénes están aquí. Carmen, look who's here. Okay, están aquí. So again, we're using the verb estar to express different feelings. And here, you use the verb estar to express location. Están aquí, are here. All right, with that in mind, in page 19, right here at the bottom, you are going to click on the escuchar and click on the cue to
Lección
answer the questions, preliminar. Okay?
¿Cómo estás?
¿Cómo estás? And what you are going to do here, you are going to listen and based on this each audio, you're going to, and what you just heard and saw in these pages, you're going to select cierto for true and falso for false, okay? Once you do that, make sure that you submit it so I get it, okay? All right, let's go. That's the first activity that you have to do today. That is in page 19. Also, we are going to go to page 19 and 20 to complete activity 17, 18, and 19, which is what we're going to do today. Okay, so in activity 17, we are going to talk about emociones, okay? To talk about emociones, we are going to use the verb estar and also the verb tener, right? So if you are happy, you say estoy alegre. If it's somebody else, like he or she, you will say está. You get rid of the R. You conjugate it. Está alegre. Está cansado o está cansada. Está enojado o está enojada, if it's a female. Está triste, if she's sad. O he is sad. Está triste. Tiene calor, if it's hot, or she's hot. Tiene hambre, he or she is hungry. Tiene miedo. Remember, tener is one of the stem-changing verbs where you have to add an I between the T and the E to conjugate it and get rid of the R. So this is the motto right here. This person right here, right? Wow, it looks hungry. So you will say, he's hungry, right? So you will use this expression right here. Tener hambre will be the expression. But you gotta conjugate it, right? You cannot say el tener hambre because it will be incorrect. You will have to change that to tiene hambre, right? What about her? What does she look like? What is her emotion? ¿Está cansada? ¿O está enojada? ¿O está triste? What do you think it is? I think she's sad. So it will be, ella está triste. The next one. Oh, he looks mad, upset. The expression is enojado o enojada. It's a male, therefore it's enojado. Está enojado. So that's what you have to do here. You're actually going to click on the question, and you're going to write down here what is it that each one of these people in this picture is looking like, right? So the first one, the cartoon, is a girl seated. The girl is leaning her head on her hand and she's crying. So she's sad. So you're going to type here, está triste. And that's it. And then complete each one of them and make sure that you submit it, okay? Just don't forget to read the descriptions. Now, the next activity is activity 18. Right here in activity 18, what you need to do, you gotta tell how someone is feeling in a situation. Okay? For example, cuando leo un libro, estoy tranquilo. So what you do here is you have to use the situation and what is it that you are feeling when you have that situation. Okay? For example, cuando leo un libro, when I read a book, I feel calm. Cuando leo un libro, estoy tranquilo. Okay? So you go here on the question, you click on the question, and it will give you the options. Right here, the options are cuando leo un libro is the motto, estoy tranquilo. Okay? Cuando tengo un examen, when I have an exam. So you will write the entire thing, cuando tengo un examen, how do you feel? Nervioso? Nervous, right? It could be. Cuando es mi cumpleaños? Then you write this whole thing here and you express how you feel. When is my birthday? I feel happy. It's activity 19 in page 20. What you're going to do here, you're going to click ¿Cómo estoy o qué tengo? What is it that you feel? Okay, take turns and using... You're going to just write here. It's supposed to record. You're going to record it. If you're in class, you're just going to write it down. If you're at home, you're going to record. For example, the first one, estoy emocionada. No, estoy nerviosa. So you're going to write a little bit of a conversation, and then you're going to submit it to express how you're feeling. Okay? For example, estoy emocionada. No, estoy nerviosa. Okay? And that is the activity that you will have to do today. I'll see you soon.